Hi, my name is Sandy Deason, and I am here today with Dan Lorenc, co-founder and CEO of Chainguard, and we're going to get smart in 5 minutes about software supply chain security. How are you, Dan?
I'm doing great today.
So how about you tell me a little bit about software supply chain security?
Sure. The easiest way to explain it is like a physical supply chain. It's all the steps that go into making the software that you get to use every day. Unlike physical supply chains, software supply chains are comprised of a bunch of different software systems and a bunch of other developers and a bunch of other people that don't necessarily work at your company. So when you're using an end package piece of software, it comes from the work of thousands of volunteers across tons of systems, across tons of companies to end up in that final piece of packaged software. Unfortunately, there's a lot of links in that chain, that supply chain, and so it's a big security problem today. Attackers are starting to attack the software supply chain instead of the end unit in the software in the very end.
And so why is this important?
Because attackers are bad people and because they've noticed that this is a problem. Attackers have gotten really good at attacking these supply chains and inserting malicious code, exploiting unintentional vulnerabilities, and being able to compromise the software that you use by attacking its supply chain rather than the software itself.
So does that mean that any security issue can be considered a software supply chain issue?
It depends. All software is used in different ways by different people. I like to say that we're all somewhere in the software supply chain and most of us are somewhere in the middle. And so security issues, if they're exploited in certain stages, can be considered software supply chain security issues. So almost any bug could be, but not all of them necessarily are.
Okay, so it's possible for there to be unintentional vulnerabilities in the software supply chain.
Of course, all software has bugs, and some of those bugs can cause security issues. The more software that you're using, the more bugs there are, and the more chance there is for there to be an unintentional security vulnerability in it.
And so there are bad people out there who are doing bad things, so how do we protect that?
Yeah, unfortunately, a lot of the software that enterprises use today is comprised of open source software. Open source software is great, but 90 to 98% of a modern application is written by people that don't work at your company and that you've never met before. That's awesome because we can reuse and build on that shared foundation, but it's terrible because if you spend any time on the internet, you realize that not everyone on the internet is nice.
So what can we do to prevent supply chain security attacks?
The first step is really the basics. It's management and understanding of your inventory. The very first step to protect is to really understand what software you're running and where your supply chain is and where it comes from. Once you get that basic understanding into place, things start to get easier. You can start to select better maintained components. You can look for things like memory safety in the software you're depending on. And you can start to update your software more frequently to fix all of those known vulnerabilities.
And so what should corporations be doing and what can consumers do to force them to protect the consumer?
Corporations should simply adopt ChainGuard images because it does all of that for them.
So there you have it. Now we know more about software supply chain security. Thank you, Dan. And how about tell me what your favorite aquatic animal is?
Well, I would say dogs, except for mine hate water, so they don't count as aquatic. But I have to go with an octopus because it's ChainGuard's mascot.
That's right. Well, thank you all. We just got smart in 5 minutes. See you next time.